welcome back to my channel. So starting out, I have a fresh face, and when I say that, I mean I don't have any foundation on. I have, of course, already done my brows and my eyes off camera, so let's get started with the tutorial. The first thing I'm going to do is take my NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk, and I'm just going to outline where I'd like the reattached face to go. So I pretty much just cut my forehead and my chin straight in half. You can go ahead and adjust the size to the shape of your face, it's totally up to you. Next, I'm taking Ben Nye's Nose and Scar Wax. Now, this product is very sticky, so what you need to do is apply some sort of a moisturizer on your hands before you use it. I roll it up into a little spaghetti-like shape, and I applied it straight onto the line in my forehead. Now, I'm taking a modeling tool that I got from iMats. You can just use any type of a flat edge, the back of your brush, or a plastic butter knife or something like that, and what I'm doing here is dragging the product down onto my forehead. Then with the warmth of my hands and a little bit more moisturizer, I'm just dabbing that out to really blend it well into the skin. And if you were wondering, they do sell many different skin tones for the Ben Nye Scar Wax, so if you're darker or lighter, you can get the one that's pretty much closest to you. Then with the spatula, I'm just going to start raising the other side of the Scar Wax. This is going to give a really lifted appearance of the skin, and you want to kind of make it a little bit bumpy and not so perfect, so give it a little bit of a rough edge as well. And then after I've done that, I'm just going to repeat the same step all of the way around my face. So I've taken another little piece of this Nose and Scar Wax, and I'm just going to blend it down and repeat the whole entire process. So after I've done that, this is what it should look like all of the way around your face. Then I'm taking some new liquid latex, which somebody has sent to me, but I'm going to be telling you guys a little bit about that later. So it's just normal liquid latex, and it comes with a little stippling sponge, but I'm going to be using a Q-tip to apply it because I really don't like throwing out my sponges for latex. So with a Q-tip, I'm just going to apply one thin layer of the latex all around the inner border of the Nose and Scar Wax, and this is just going to pretty much hold it on, and it's not going to come off throughout the day or the night. After I've done that, I'm also going to apply little blobs of this all over my forehead and my chin, and this is going to give a nice texture for when we're applying that meaty, fleshy skin later on. I'm then taking my usual liquid foundation and applying this with a kabuki brush, and I'm going to be applying a fair amount of this just to get a really even, really perfect complexion, so then I can blend in the Nose and Scar Wax with my skin tone. So after I've applied that on my face, I'm then taking a paintbrush with more of the foundation, and I'm going to really heavily apply that around the border of the Nose and Scar Wax just to blend it into my skin. And after I've done all of that, I'm just going to run over the whole thing with a beauty blender just to make sure that it all blends seamlessly and actually looks like my skin, not like something's been stuck on my face. Next, we need to set all of that in place, so I'm just taking my Australis Fresh and Flawless Powder Foundation, and you really, really need to pack this on densely on the Nose and Scar Wax because it has such a shiny consistency. We really need to mattify the whole thing, and we need to try to make this look as realistic as possible, so you want to just go ahead and pack that on until you feel like it looks like your real skin. Next, I'm going in with a black grease face paint and a fine detailing brush, and I'm just going to really messily apply this right underneath the border of the Nose and Scar Wax. This is going to give it a lot of depth and really draw it back, so the face is going to look a lot more further away than it actually is. Then I'm going to be taking Ben Nye Stackable Grease Paints in the shade Maroon, and I'm going to be really messily applying this and blending that in with the black that we previously applied. And then you really want to try to give the illusion of a receded hairline. So what we're going to do is we're going to blend that right up into your hairline as much as you possibly can and just create that overall messy and meaty texture on your face by really stippling the paint, and we're going to be layering different colours of reds to give it more texture and to make it look a lot more realistic. So you pretty much want to run that all of the way around the whole entire border of your face. So now I'm taking the colour Cherry Red and that same stippling brush, and I'm just going to really stipple that colour on in random places to give it more of a meaty texture and more of a colour variety. And again, we're just going to keep bringing that up into our hairline as much as possible. And I'm taking Ben Nye's Fresh Scab, and it's pretty much just a shiny blood gel that doesn't dry. If you leave the lid off it, the pot will dry itself, but when you're applying it on your makeup and you leave it on for hours, it doesn't actually dry on your face, which is a little bit bizarre. So what I'm doing is taking a Q-tip and just really sparsely applying little chunks and big chunks to give nice texture and nice shine to the look. Then after that, I'm taking my big bottle of fake blood that was also sent to me. And I love the colour of this blood because it's very similar to the Ben Nye Dark Blood. And I really love that colour, so it's really perfect for me. And I'm using that stippling sponge that they gave me with the latex. And I'm just going to start really lightly stippling blood all around the sides of my face to give it that little splattered effect. Once I felt like I had enough stippling going on, I then went in with that same blood and same sponge and a really heavy hand and started to apply big blobs of blood to darken up the whole look. And you can go ahead and do this to your liking, but of course I love blood, so I'm going to apply heaps and heaps. Then after that, I'm also going in with that same stippling brush, and I'm just going to really roughly stipple in that blood as well, because using different mediums gives you a really awesome finish, because you've got a sponge and you've got a brush going on and then you've got the blood. The whole thing just works out really well. Then I'm taking a black grease paint again and a small detailing brush, and I'm just going to draw on little random blobs and circles everywhere, and this is kind of going to give it a really burnt and charcoal effect, or just a really sore and blistered effect in general. And with the same black grease paint, I lightly applied that around the border of the fake skin just to give it a little bit more depth to really separate it from the face. Then I'm taking an old mask from an old tutorial of mine, and I'm going to be pinching the staples out of it because I couldn't find staples around my house. So it's pretty much just a few staples bundled together with one of the ends pinched. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to dig that deep into the scar wax, and it should just sit in place. You won't need to apply any latex over the top. It is a little bit fiddly, but it stays once it's in there. So go ahead and apply as many or as little as you like. And if you don't want to use staples, you can go crazy with this. You can put like nails or string to make it look like it's been sewn back together. You can get really creative with this part and just have fun with it. So to finish off the tutorial, all I did was I scruffed up my hair really intensely because I wanted this look to be really crazy and really messy, and I felt like leaving my hair up in a ponytail showed a lot more of the detail, so I didn't take my hair down. And yeah, that was pretty much the whole entire look. I loved how gory this turned out and how seamlessly the scar wax blended off into my skin. I was really impressed with it and I really loved the way it worked out. Of course, you can always change up the style. You don't have to put too much blood. This look was actually inspired by a girl who entered my contest. She did such an amazing job. Her name is Bash, and this is her contest entry that she sent me. I loved how she did her skin really rotted and she actually sewn the face on, and I thought it just looked great with the beautiful makeup next to it. I really loved her entry, so I felt like I had to recreate it and put my own spin on it. And if she has a blog, if you want to check it out, I'll leave it in the description box below. So you guys are always asking me as well where I get my fake blood from and where I get my latex from. I actually had a lady contact me from costumesupercenter.com.au, and they have a whole bunch of prosthetics and costumes and fake blood, and she was kind enough to send me a whole bunch of stuff. She sent me some latex and some fake blood and some fangs, and it's not like every day you get stuff for free, so I really appreciate that. And if you also want to go check that out, I'll leave it in the description box below. I really appreciate everyone for watching my videos and for subscribing. Please leave any suggestions because Halloween is right around the corner. I love you all so much, and please stay safe. See you in my next video, guys. Bye.